My old Guillow Spirit of St. Louis was flown years ago with a Cox .020 Peewee Guillow engine. Now updated to electric with a very small brushless motor and controlled using our DX6i transmitter and Spectrum miniature receiver installed, giving full house 4-channel control. Rudder, elevator, motor, and aileron control. To provide this combination, I used 4 of these miniature servos, 3 actually, one for ailerons, one for elevator, and one for rudder control. I recently added a miniature autopilot unit which senses changes in attitude that were not directed by the transmitter inputs. When she deviates from the transmitter input attitudes, the autopilot puts in the correction value. As a rule, if the left wing dips, the left elevator goes down and the right elevator comes up. As a rule, large serious deflections are to be avoided on the initial flights, and the sensitivity levels are initially set to low. Thing for y'all, you have to look closely to see the correction being put in. Yawing to the right puts in left rudder, and the opposite rudder for yawing in the opposite direction. To get the correct setting on the autopilot unit, I had to increase the sensitivity to its maximum and then note the input to the surfaces to to decide whether they needed to be reversed or they were okay as they were set up. I ended up, to get the thing right, I had to reverse the direction on two channels, the aileron and the elevator, no, rudder channel it was. But now I'm confident that they're all working in the correct manner. Let's take the thing apart and so that I can show you what the tiny autopilot unit looks like. We see mostly a tangle of wires. They don't weigh that much and could easily be cleaned up by hard wiring. Looking at the autopilot, you see a series of dip switches. For the radio channels, rudder, elevator, aileron and auxiliary. There are switches for four channels plus two wing configurations. You can see switches for all channels with reverse and normal positions, and switches for V-tail and delta wing setups. The unit itself weighs only 5 grams. Reverse and normal with these dip switches. There's even dip switches for a delta wing and for a V-tail. Tiny little unit, could be fitted into the smallest of the models. Actually, it only weighs a few grams. Is a Spectrum AR6120. I guess it is a 6-channel receiver. The battery we are using in the model is made up from two mini drone batteries wired together in series, giving an output voltage of 7.4 volts. Enough to give sufficient power to fly the model.